Hello guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Till now, I have made videos on various series like Attack on Titan, Demon Slayer, Naruto, One Piece, JoJo, Bleach and many more. But I have never made any videos about ReZero. And not a long time ago, I just realized that ReZero has a lot of mysteries in it. And more than any mysteries, ReZero is in first hand very confusing. First season is very straight up with a simple story. But the things get harder to understand in the second season. And I also have seen that not many people are covering these topics in their videos on YouTube. So, on this channel, we are going to start a series where I will be explaining different things from ReZero which confuses many people. So, if you are interested in this series and haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel yet, then make sure to do it so you won't miss any video about ReZero. So in today's video, we are going over a topic which confuses many people in the start of the second season. What is Sanctuary? What exactly is that thing? Why people are trapped in there? And who are those people? And why Emilia is trying to save all of those people? Let's start with our video and start answering these questions one by one. The Sanctuary first gets talked about towards the end of the ReZero season 1, when Irlam village is on the verge of being attacked by Petrugius Romane Conti and his fingers.
Petrugius Romane Conti.
Yes!
And to be safe from that attack, some of the people from the village goes to a safe place called as Sanctuary. In that point in time, the Sanctuary was under the protection and the control of Roswal family. In short, our clown Roswal L. Mathers. However, in ReZero season 2, we realize that the Sanctuary is not exactly a sanctuary. After dealing with the matter of Petrugius Romane Conti, Subaru and Emilia visits the sanctuary to bring back the residents of the Irlam village back to their home. Also with the villagers, Roswal himself was staying in that sanctuary. To their surprise, sanctuary is nothing as they imagined it to be. Rather, it is a small village located in the forest of Kremeldin. The village is very poor, with all the ruined buildings where the villagers were taking shelter at. Plus, Subaru and Emilia also realizes that Sanctuary is a place where all the demi-humans or the half-humans live. Everything is looking fine for the Sanctuary until Subaru and Emilia realizes that the people who enter the Sanctuary are trapped inside. They understand from the demi-humans that the Sanctuary is also called as Witch's Graveyard, which eventually puts a barrier around the place of the Sanctuary which stops anyone from leaving. Especially demi-humans who cannot leave the sanctuary at all cost. They are all bound to live there and die there forever. After they meet Roswal in the sanctuary, Roswal requests Emilia to help him to get all the demi-humans out of the sanctuary. Emilia of course accepts the request to help the people living there and stays there. In short, the sanctuary is a village which was created by the witch of greed Echidona 400 years ago. It is currently her resting place and is under the supervision of Roswal family. Now the next thing I'm going to talk about contains some minor spoilers from the arc 4 of the ReZero, which is not appeared in the anime yet. So spoilers warning to you guys. Don't comment now that I didn't warn you about the spoilers from the light novel. But even though if you are just anime watcher, you can still continue watching because these are not any big spoilers. These are just the minor spoilers which you are gonna understand in the next season of the ReZero. 400 years ago, the time when witches used to roam freely is the time when they possessed the whole world, so they had nothing to fear about. In those older times, half-humans or demi-humans was a race which was treated very badly by humans living in that time. They were discriminated because they are half-humans. That's why to help those half-humans, Witch of Greed Echidona created this sanctuary so that demi-humans or the humans with mixed blood could live there without fear of the outside world. Echidona assures them that they would be safe inside the sanctuary, and then she uses their mana in order to create a barrier that would protect the place. But in reality, the sanctuary was built for Echidona's personal reasons. In the past, Echidona supposedly had a huge rivalry with Hector, who was known as the warlord of Demon of Melakni. While not much has been revealed about Hector in ReZero, it is implied that he was stronger than Echidona and that she was being pursued by him. Echidona is a witch known for her vast knowledge and not for her fighting prowess. And hence, she had to come up with a cunning solution in order to stop Hector. But only the mana of the half-humans living in the sanctuary was not enough for the Hector to stop entering the sanctuary. As the sanctuary was the living place of the Echidona, it would be the safest place for her to stay if she could create a perfect barrier. But unfortunately, Hector finds out where the Echidona is staying right now. Now after that, Echidona understands that Hector is on the way to the sanctuary, and Echidona starts working hard in the preparation of completing the barrier. For this purpose, she chooses to help Ryuzu Mayor, who was one of the demi-humans living in that sanctuary. And as Echidona helped all the demi-humans to stay safe in the sanctuary, Ryuzu agrees to help the Witch of Envy. In order to help this happen, Roswal offers to stall Hector and tries to buy Echidona some time to complete her process. But in the process of stopping the guy who is more powerful than Echidona, Roswal gets injured very badly, but somehow he survives the battle. But even though he survives, we still don't know how he manages to get some traits of Hector. As you can see, both looks almost the same with the makeup and the clothing. As I have talked earlier, Ryuzu Mayor agrees to help Echidona, and that's why Ryuzu Mayor willingly turns herself into a crystal in order to help Echidona, which will eventually form a barrier around the sanctuary and protect all the people. And that's why since then, the barrier has prevented anyone with the half-blood from exiting the sanctuary. As we all know that Echidona was a witch of greed, and hence she was greedy about knowledge and wanted to know everything in this world. One of the biggest motives of the Echidona was to create immortality, and to do that she was living in the sanctuary. After Ryuzu turned herself into crystal, Echidona used her powers to make her clones and start experimenting on them for immortality. This continues till the time she was swallowed by the Witch of Envy Satela, and her soul was sealed by the dragon Volcania. After Echidona was sealed, the sanctuary was under the care of Roswal family. In order to break these barriers surrounding the sanctuary, one has to partake in the trial that are carried out in the Echidona's tomb. If the one who is taking the trials gets successful, the half-humans living inside the sanctuary becomes free to move anywhere they want and live wherever they wish. At Roswal's behest, Emilia decides to take the trials in order to free the demi-humans trapped in the sanctuary. At the current stage in the ReZero anime, Emilia passes all the trials held by the Echidona. She not just passes the trials, but exceeds the expectations of the witch, that kind of makes Echidona surprised. Now, what exactly are the three trials which Echidona and Subaru went through is a different question, which we will cover in another video which will be just dedicated to the trials of the sanctuary. So if you want to know that and understand many mysteries and confusing things in ReZero anime, then just subscribe to my YouTube channel for more content. And just let me know in the comment section down below what things are you confused with in the ReZero. So I will explain it in the separate videos. And I think that was for the today's video, guys. If you enjoyed this video, just don't forget to like this video, subscribe to my YouTube channel, because I post daily anime content about top 10 top 5 listings, anime reviews, recommendations, news, theories and all sort of anime content on daily basis. So if you enjoyed, please subscribe, and that was it. And I will see you in the next one. Sayonara.